In on Mixing in the Kitchen, Hollywood in the Park. Well, today I'm going to make turkey carnitas. And the first thing I'm doing is I am rinsing out the turkey because God only knows where this stuff has been. Okay, I'm just saying. Or who's touched it. So I always rinse it out really thoroughly in a pot. Let it soak for a minute. And then I put it to boil.
So I have the pot here. And I'm going to boil it, but while I'm boiling, I like to put a few things in. So I like to put the garlic salt, Lori's garlic salt. And again, it's to your taste, right? Just for it to get the water to get into the chicken. And then I put this pollo asado seasoning, even though it's turkey, I put pollo asado seasoning in it. And again, this is for, and I'm gonna, eventually the water's going to like, fizzle out, okay? And then I like to add garlic powder to it. I love a lot of garlic. Oh my God, I love a lot of garlic. I ain't even gonna lie. Okay, I love a lot of garlic? Okay, so I'm gonna put that in there. And then I like to add a little bit of caldo de tomate con sabor de pollo. Again, this is just to the water. And then we'll just, good Latina would be without her cumin. So let me get some cumin. And you know what, I buy it from the Indian store because they give you the best price and they give you a whole bag full, okay? And this is called Shah's Deer Brand Cumin Powder. Whatever the hell, I don't know, but anyways. It's, they give you a lot of cumin, and I'm gonna put the cumin in there, okay? And what I like also to do, and because we're making carnitas, right? I like to add some oil to it. And I am going to, right now, I'm going to use this butter flavor Crisco oil. And even though the turkey has a little bit, it has the, you know, the skin and stuff, and it makes its own fat, I like to add a little bit more fat because, you know, the carnitas, they have to have a little bit more fat in it. And I like using this. I remember I used to use this a long time ago. And you know what? It's definitely time to start using it again because it gives that butter flavor and then that fat that you need. And this is vegetable oil. Okay? I'm just going to add about 2 big heaping tablespoons. And that's it. Not that much. Okay? So I'm gonna let that to boil, and I will let you know how this came out.
Whiskey sour, popular, girl, get me zone. Whiskey sour, popular, girl, get me zone. Join Techeetah Lopez and Hollywood in the Park's entire audience by advertising your brand, product, or personality with your commercial here. Email techeetah@gmail.com for more info.
She's been cooking all day. Smells so good and saucy. Red love, let me get a taste. In the morning with some eggs. Yeah.
Okay, now it is to boil. Now you see, it still has a lot left to go. So what happens is you let it boil and you let it boil until literally all the water and the flavor has boiled out and you get it down to the bottom. And I will show you the next step right when it gets all the way to the bottom. And it takes a while. It takes about, from beginning to end, it takes about a good, I don't know, 3 hours, I think, sometimes.
Now, if your turkey is a little bit dry, then if you want, and now I have real butter, and then I have plant butter, right? So when I cook like cookies and things like that, sometimes I want to use real butter, but the majority of the time I do use the plant butter. So what I'm going to do is just soften up the turkey, and I'm going to put a stick of plant butter in there. So I put the stick in there and I'm gonna let it melt, and then again I'm gonna let it simmer, and I'm gonna toss it around until it literally falls off the bone. Okay, and you see the water's almost all gone, and again it is a process, so it's going on about a couple hours now, but more than about 2.5 hours now. So I'm gonna go ahead and cover this up and
okay,
just let
let's
it sit.
See what we have here.
Ooh, look at that. It is falling off the freaking bone. Oh yeah, look at that. Falling off the bone. Look at that. Ooh, yep. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Look at that. Off the bone. That's what you want. And then of course you get that little crispiness. So I don't know if you've ever had carnitas, Latino market, but it has a little crispiness to it. So I'm going to let it sit there still some more, maybe about 10 more minutes or so.
Okay,
so look at this. It fell all off the bone. See, my hands are clean. Sorry. But anyway, yep. So all that's left is a little bit of fat that's on the bottom, and it fall off the bone. See that? Wow. Look at even the breast, not the breast, but the thigh. So this is just like thighs, leg thigh and the leg thigh. Thighs and legs, okay. Your language right, Techeetah. But anyway, it is ready for whatever you want. For turkey carnita burritos, or to have with rice or beans, or however you want. Okay, so that right there is my recipe for turkey carnitas. A better, healthier way than your typical pork. All right, and this is your turkey carnitas episode on mixing in the kitchen with the Queen of Salsa Soul.